As life goes on, almost everything changes, but
some things never change.
Like Washington disappointing me every Sunday. It doesn't matter how good the team is, or what new shiny free agent has been brought in. Somehow, it always goes south. Washington has used a first-round pick on a defensive player for each of the last 5 seasons, yet the defense is still terrible. Since Kirk Cousins left in 2017, Washington has started 9 different quarterbacks in only 4 years, including current starter Taylor Heinicke, who was a backup in the XFL less than 2 years ago. Washington hasn't won a playoff game since 2005. For context, the late great Sean Taylor had the iconic fumble return against Tampa Bay in that victory. Fast forward about 16 years, and so much has changed. John Gruden stood on the Buccaneers sideline during that loss. Now he's being wrapped up in the Washington email scandal, prompting his resignation from the Raiders, while Washington likely attempted to sweep the controversy under the rug by announcing the retirement of Sean Taylor's number the same week of a game. It's hard to be consistently bad and fail expectations every season, but it's easier to do under bad ownership. But if you want more content like this, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss any new videos. Washington came into 2021 with high expectations for the first time in years, mainly due to a defense that finished second best in the league a season prior. Washington used first-round picks on the defense for 5 straight years, selecting Jonathan Allen, Daron Payne, Montez Sweat, Chase Young, and Jamin Davis. But it hasn't been the line that's been the issue. Washington has given up a league-high 1,857 yards, 98 first downs, and 52 third-down conversions. They have been easily the most disappointing unit in football based on expectations, a lot due to inconsistencies and struggles in the secondary. There was an expectation for the defense to carry a weak offense, but it hasn't lived up to the hype, and the offense is just as bad as everyone expected, if not worse. Ryan Fitzpatrick was the expected starter, but he went down in week 1, and Taylor Heinicke was forced to step in. Washington had high hopes of the playoffs on the back of a journeyman, but their efforts now sit in the hands of a guy who was a backup in the XFL less than 2 years ago. But it hasn't been all doom and gloom. Heinicke can make mind-boggling plays, or go on the run and dive for the pylon in dramatic fashion while putting his team on the back. But he can also overthrow his receivers by 10 yards and throw into terrible coverage consistently. He's damn fun to watch, but he's really, really frustrating. Terry McLaurin is still the number one guy, and he's continuing to groom into one of the best wideouts in the league. But he's the only true threat in the passing game. Washington signed Curtis Samuel in the offseason, but he spent a large majority of the year injured. Additionally, both tight end Logan Thomas and guard Brandon Scherff are dealing with injuries, only adding to the fire. Yet the recent talk about Washington has nothing to do with what is happening on the field. Instead, it's focused on the dysfunction in the front office. The NFL investigation into Washington's workplace misconduct somehow didn't reveal anything inside the organization, but did bring John Gruden's emails to life that led to his resignation and put Adam Schefter in hot water after some questionable reporting tactics where he sent an article to Washington's general manager Bruce Allen to edit. Look, there's no way that there was not anything crazy in those emails that had to do with Washington. The report was apparently an oral report, so there's no paper trail to follow. With the whole Gruden situation going down, Washington got dragged down too, mainly because it was literally their fault. So what would any reasonable team do? Probably release a statement and say, you know, how they can change things and that they're being better. But what did Washington do? Well, they announced that they would be retiring one of their most beloved players in franchise history's jersey just days before a game. I'm not sure how they expected that to go over, but it wasn't good. Literally everybody bashed the organization, and for good reason. What's really crazy is that somehow, because of everything that's been going on in Washington, the fact that their head trainer was raided by the DEA at the Washington facility because he was allegedly distributing prescription drugs has just been completely snuck under the carpet with no one really paying attention to it.
What the fuck?
The culture has definitely changed under Ron Rivera, but the problem roots deep in ownership more than anything. Dan Snyder has probably been the worst owner in the NFL since he took ownership in 1999.
Are you sure about that?
His actual personnel decisions have been just drastically bad. In his first few years, Snyder fired general manager Charlie Casserly, signed Deion Sanders to a monster deal before he decided to retire after one season, fired Norv Turner during the season at 7-6 even after a slew of previous success in Washington, hired and fired Marty Schottenheimer in one year, even though Washington finished hot at 8-3, hired Steve Spurrier, who literally had no success in the pros after coming over from Florida, and then decided to hire Joe Gibbs for a second stint. Now, Gibbs did have some success, and he even won a playoff game, their last postseason victory in 2005. After Gibbs retired, Jim Zorn was hired and lasted for 2 years before hiring Mike Shanahan. Under Zorn, Snyder famously gave Albert Haynesworth a 7-year, $100 million deal just to be traded less than two seasons later for a fifth-round pick. General manager Vinny Serrato decided to resign, and a new era ensued in Washington under Bruce Allen. An era of damn good culture.
You know, the culture is actually damn good.
Psych! That's the wrong number!
The culture included forcing cheerleaders to be male escorts, firing Shanahan after the mismanagement of Robert Griffin III that ended his career, hiring Jay Gruden, firing general manager Scott McLuhan, and blaming it on his alcohol issues. And then firing Gruden after the two disagreed on drafting Dwayne Haskins. Finally, 2020 represented a new start for Washington that was desperately needed, and they decided to hire Ron Rivera to help them get there. Soon after, Washington changed their name from the Redskins, and it looked like things were on the up, but the past was still catching up. The Washington Post reported that Washington had many women accuse employees of sexual harassment and followed it up with another story to bring the total number of accusers to 42. Everything under Snyder has gone horribly. And in March, he bought out the minority owners to become the 100% owner of the team.
No, God!
Growing up a Washington fan and constantly seeing the mismanagement of the front office and the roster has been awful. Coming into the year, there was so much talk about how it was a new team and the defense was going to carry them to the playoffs, but I thought it had to be taken with a grain of salt. No matter what has happened in my lifetime, Washington has always found a way to mess it up. I really don't remember any Washington playoff wins in my life. My main distinct memories are losses to the Packers when Kirk Cousins was here and to the Seahawks during Robert Griffin III's rookie year. I don't think anything will ever be able to compare to how magical that season was. I mean, he came out of nowhere and made Washington a top team in the league down the stretch, but in typical fashion, it all blew up in their face. Now, in no way am I a Detroit Lions fan, luckily, but it hasn't been fun rooting for Washington over the years. Before the name change, I had been to 18 Washington regular season games in my lifetime. They lost every single one. No matter what happens, and no matter how much people hype up Washington, it's hard to believe that it's truly going to change. Great NFL franchises are able to be successful in the front office, and then it shows on the field. But as long as Dan Snyder is in control in Washington, the future is bleak. Hey, if you enjoyed the video, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you never miss a daily upload. Make sure to follow us on TikTok, where we're going to be uploading content all season long, and check us out on Instagram and Twitter to interact with us and talk all things sports.